What's up, everybody? So I'm going to talk a little bit about my throwing chicken version 4 Proton thrower with Pop Mech. The reason I'm making this video is because during my build of my Proton pack, I've been building it for almost 2 years now. One of the things that I have been trying to find, just the hardest part about it, was building this guy right here, the Proton thrower. I've got a lot of insight from a lot of people that been able to give me some little snippets of things here and there, but as far as pictures or videos or anything like that, that's been a little hard to come across. So I'm hoping that this will help out a lot of you guys in the future that are looking to build this version. So what this is again, this is the throwing chicken version 4 with Pop Mech. It's from a throwing chicken is from a guy named Justin Black. So props to Justin for putting this together, designing this, doing the whole thing. It is resin with metal parts kind of both together, so it comes with a kit that you get pretty much everything that you need, minus the electronics and the tube up here, which I'm going to talk about. There's some other parts that go along with it as well, but it's a pretty solid kit. I would definitely recommend it. What I'm going to do in this video too is give you some tips and tricks on how to put it together, specifically with the GB Fans wand light kit. This combination seems to be the hardest combination of both the proton gun and the electronics kit, mainly because, and I'll just kind of give you a precursor to it, but this is the Pop Mech that goes into the proton thrower. This Pop Mech and this board are some of the larger, bulkier parts that you'll find in this kind of build here. A lot of other kits, Ninja Tunes kits, whatever other electronics, the boards seem to be a lot smaller than this, as well as other Pop Mechs that are available for just any kind of proton thrower are a lot smaller than this as well. So this is kind of like your, I don't want to like say that this is like the hardest setup, but it was pretty hard for me. But again, I want to be able to help out anybody else that's doing this exact combination and maybe help out anybody else that's doing just any kind of proton thrower combination setup. But so I want to give you some rundowns of how I put this together so far. And just, again, this is my setup. You can do what you like if you're going for movie accuracy, which I was not, just kind of workarounds that I had found and developed as I was building some things. So first off, I want to talk about the interior stuff and my wiring. My vent light was one of the things that I was trying to figure out how I wanted to fit that in there and to make sure that it kind of reflects a little bit more. Now, there are some kits out there that you can purchase the vent light on the inside, the reflector cup, or if you wanted to do like a flashlight reflector cup. What I did for mine, just a real simple workaround, I just took tin foil and I folded it up, kind of made a cup shape. You can kind of see it in there right now. There we go. Nothing too crazy, but folded it up, wrapped it around the light bulb. Well, actually, I folded it up itself. Then I placed the cup into the gearbox or the gun box, poked a hole in the center, fit my bulb through, and then just hot glued it, and it works perfectly fine for me. Pretty bright in there, reflects a lot of light. The what I would say for that, if you are doing whether it be something like this or an actual like reflector cup or reflector light or whatever, is to make sure that this section is separate from the other blinking lights that you will have with your light kit. So, what I mean is that if you have any kind of gaps in between your reflector cup in here with your vent light, that light from the blinking lights right here on the sides is going to show up in your vent light right here. So what I did was I put a little piece of just a piece of paper, actually, or a little thin piece of cardboard in between The lights that I had coming through the top of the gun box and the reflector for the vent light. It's kind of hard to see in there, but it is in there, so it kind of just makes a wall so that there's no light shining between the blinking light and the vent light right here. So there's some differentiation between them. So what I did with that, actually, I think that's pretty much it for the vent light. Something else that I did for my build is with this board, this GB fans board, you get all of the switches, all of the cables, the lights, the bulbs, everything you need. What I kind of found was that the switches were very small. I didn't really care much for the size of the original switches. Now, what I did was I cut off those switches and soldered on some larger, more sturdy switches, which I just got these on Amazon. I feel like they work a lot better. They have a better feel to them. They click a lot harder. It's not terribly hard, but it definitely is better than these tiny little, they just seem kind of like flimsy switches that came with those, with the GB fans board. So I switched those out. What I did was I connected those with 22 gauge wire. So that's what I used here. I asked around a little bit to see what kind of wire would work for these electronics. Excuse me. But everybody had been pointing me to this. This seems to work perfectly fine. So that made my connection between my switches, and I connected them to the remaining wire that is going to connect to my board. So new switches, 22 gauge wire, connect them to the remaining wire, and then it'll just snap right back on here. So that's the majority of like the electronics alterations that I did. So now I'm going to lead into the pop mech. So again, here is the fully assembled pop mech that comes with this kit here. So when you get it, it comes in a couple different, it's 3D printed, a couple different plates of 3D printed parts. You just kind of pop them out, shave off the little excess that is not needed for all these parts, piece them together, and then you get a couple of these hex screws. I know that there's official names for these screws, but we'll just call them hex screws for the hell of it. But you piece it all together, you get this metal rod, which you have to bend yourself to your liking, the way you want to shape it. You'll piece everything together, put this little rubber piece, or sorry, the part of the hose that is this part right here. I just took a little excess piece of it. I believe that's what you're supposed to do anyway. You'll get the spring. You do not get the clear tube. At least I didn't get it in this the most recent kit. I don't know if that's going to change in the future, but I got the tube from GB Fans. I also got the end of the barrel piece. I forget what that's called again as well. Got that from GB Fans. This whole setup, the throwing chicken kit, came with the banjos. The banjos are resin printed or resin created, however you want to say. I purchased just some regular screws from, I believe it was Menards. You can get them from Menards or Ace Hardware or Home Depot, whatever, but I just got some gold screws that match the fitting or the threads for this metal piece up here. But basically, it does come with pretty much everything else that you'll need for it to work with the Proton thrower itself. So this is the completed, assembled pop mech that is going to go into the gun box. So I'm going to show you how this was put together, how it's going to work, and how it's going to piece together basically in the gun box itself. So this is the lever piece. What you're going to need to do with there's some extra pieces that it comes with. I didn't feel like I needed it, or that you might not even need. There are some people that know how to work these extra pieces. I'll try to cover some of those, but there are, let's see here. The first thing that I ran into is that you'll need to, when you're looking at this, we'll call this the lever piece because it's activated by the lever here. I'll give a demonstration at the end, but this lever piece, you're supposed to fit these tiny little metal wheels into here, which the actual lever feeds through the box and is supposed to, when you press down on it, it's supposed to lift up the lever. I know this is just kind of a really, I'll give you a better demonstration, don't worry. But when you fit the wheel in here, or the wheel, it's these two little wheels on either side come with these tiny, really small little screws in the wheels. And I believe that those are meant to be able to tighten onto the metal rod once you fit it through. These do not work. Take these out, get rid of them. I don't know if they came with the wheel or if they were meant to hopefully hold onto it, but they do not. So take them out, get rid of them. You don't need them. The hex screws, the smaller hex screws, will fit in here. You don't need any super large ones. The smaller ones will fit. They're easier to latch onto, to reach with your Allen wrench. So this works a lot better. It holds on a lot tighter. You'll need two of them, not just one. You'll need two, and then you'll ultimately fit the rod through here through the gearbox. So it'll kind of fit in like that underneath, but we'll show you at the end what that looks like. So that's tip number one. Get rid of these tiny little screws right here. Again, you don't need those. This will be your, we'll call this for a better term, the rail. This is where the actual barrel piece or whatever is going to slide through. This is going to guide everything. As we're building this, we'll call this the top of the rail or the top of the whole pop mech. I say top because this is just how we're working at it right now. It's actually the bottom of it when you're holding the gun right side up. But as we're looking at it right now, we'll just call this part of the rail, this part of the pop mech, the top. Now, if you're looking at it, you can see that there's part of it that's angled for whatever reason. So this is going to fit in a specific way into the gearbox, just like this, after everything. Here's the other side of the rail, just like that. But if you notice, there are also indentations in specific spots in the build overall. But believe that is meant to be able to fit your wires through. If you're wanting to put, see how you have your lights or buttons and wires coming down through the barrel. These are supposed to affect your I believe it's called the ear buttons, lights, what have you. But I have mine fed through the actual body of the box, which if I pull this through a little bit, just like this, I wrapped it up with some electrical tape so it's not completely exposed. Gives it a better look, but I don't need to fit this through the rail. It'll just go over on top, which is perfectly fine. But if you have your wires feeding through the barrel, it's going to come out this hole down here, and it's going to need a space to come into the box, which is what this is for. So you'll feed it through the hole, and it'll come out of this little piece right here on the side. So hopefully that makes sense. You can do it how you like, really, but this is just how I have mine set up. So I'm gonna show you how I put the pop mech together, basically. Again, there's other pieces that this came with that I just feel like didn't really need to be used. It might be better if they were used, but I've already tried this. It seemed to be working fine without it. So if you want to go with this setup, it should work pretty much all right. But here is the assembly of the rail with the, we'll call this the barrel rod. And then if you were to put in the lever fits in underneath. You push in the barrel and it locks in. So there are the screws are here on the lever. Once you lift it up, or push it down, I should say, it lifts up and it releases. This screw on the lever latches into this little indentation in the rod. So again, I'll show you how that works. Once everything is in the gearbox or in the gun box, push it through, it latches down because there are rubber bands that are supposed to be here pulling them together. And once you push it down, it lifts up and releases and pushes through. So that's basically what it's supposed to look like. Now again, this is the top, so to speak, right now. So this is how it's gonna sit in the gun box. And I'll show you how we're gonna put that together shortly. So I'll take this apart one more time, slide it through. I'm gonna take this out for now, put that right there. We're gonna work on putting this stuff together in here next. So since I have the lever right now already placed into, or I'm sorry, the lever placed into the actual lever piece on the inside here, I'm going to take this out so that we can fit everything together. So I'm just gonna loosen these screws up a little bit. And I just put them together temporarily to show everybody what that's gonna look like at the end of everything. So just enough to be able to pull this guy apart. So we'll save this for later. So here is my suggestion for the build. While the throwing chicken version 4, I don't know what the other versions look like before this, is a very good build. I feel like because the pop mech itself seems to be rather bulky, it is kind of hard to, you know, manage what people have been referencing as the rat's nest. It is kind of hard to kind of fit everything in there. It's a big mess, big pile of spaghetti just kind of thrown in there, trying to manage it around this big bulky pop mech here, but we can make it work. So originally, I'll try to wiggle around these guys right here too. There is what I've been kind of referencing is a mounting piece within the resin build. There's an angled section of this interior of the gun box that I believe you're supposed to be able to mount the board and screw it directly into here. While I see how that would have worked, it's still pretty tight, and you know, if there was an original intention for how that would have worked, I haven't seen anything out there, so like how we would have been able to do that, that was the hard part. So what I did was I literally just carved that whole section out. So and here's another tip with this, to be able to fit in specifically the GB boards or the GB fans board, because it's kind of big, into this gun box. If you carve out that section there, it's a lot easier to fit this piece in here. Now, again, my tip for this, if you were to do this setup and you're gonna be carving this piece out right here, do so very carefully. So you can see what I did was I took my drill, just kind of drilled through, I took some pliers and just kind of broke it out very carefully, but there was one instance where my drill went all the way through on accident. So now I've got a little hole coming through the top of my gun box. You can see it right here. I don't know if you can see it on the camera here, but yep, there it is right there. So what I'm gonna do for this now, it's not terrible. I'm just gonna put another hex screw through the top to fill that hole, a smaller one so it doesn't come through and kind of contact the board or do anything on the interior, but it's a pretty easy fix. At least I'm not gonna care too much about what that's gonna look like from the top. But that is something that I would definitely suggest. If you're gonna be carving this out, do so carefully. I don't know, use a Dremel, use some kind of rotary tool, whatever you're gonna use to carve this out. Try to do it just slowly, carefully enough so that your tool doesn't mess up the outside of the gun box. But now that I've got that piece taken out, the rest of this will fit in here pretty easily. I don't have to worry about things sitting at an angle, which is what this would have looked like originally, and trying to figure out how to get my cables and everything through here. I don't know if it was supposed to be meant where this board is supposed to be flipped and all the cables face the other way into the gun box. But again, I don't know how that would have worked, but it's just easier to just have it not there altogether. But my next step, if you're building this, would be to what I'm going to say is you're going to need to feed all your wires and everything through first. So your barrel wires, connect your trigger wires, everything through here, your vent light, your ribbon for your bar graph down here, which my bar graph I just hot glued in there. It seems to be holding just fine. The cable that is connected all the way, or sorry, the I forget how long the cable is, but the cable that connects all the way through the split loom all the way to the actual proton pack itself. Feed everything through and make sure it's sitting where it needs to sit. So we're going to leave the board out for now, and then kind of place everything on the outside. We'll wrap this around here for now. Be careful with stuff. Be gentle with stuff. This guy wants to keep coming back up. But the pop mech is going to sit on top of this stuff right here. So we're just going to move these gently over to the side. Just like that. Now putting in your, or assembling the installing, I'll say, installing the pop mech. So what I did was I pieced it, just these two parts together first, the rail and the lever. Again, this is the top right now because this is the top of the gearbox or the gun box, sorry. But this is going to sit in here. The lever is going to sit underneath. And we're going to fit it just like this. Very simple. Now there is a hex screw. Let's see if we can see it. It's a little hard to see right now, but there's a hex screw. I'll just take it back out again and I'll show you. This little screw right here is going to hold this. There's supposed to be two of them. I'm actually just going to use one because one held enough. I'm afraid that if I put another screw in here, it's going to come out the top of the gun box. I don't want to do that. I've already done it with one and it's holding fine. So this screw is going to hold the rail into the gun box. So we're going to fit both of them in at the same time. Just like that. And now I'm going to reach through with my Allen wrench. You know what I would also say too? I bought one of these guys with different size wrenches in here too. If they're long enough to reach where I'm gonna reach, sometimes it's easier to use this because I keep dropping this guy, it keeps falling on my hands, whatever. But if you come across one of these, I would definitely say get it. It's been a lifesaver during my build so far. But I'm gonna tighten this screw in here and then I'm gonna show you how to manage the rest of this here. All right, now we're actually going to put in the barrel piece. Now, what I probably should have shown you beforehand, before I put the, I just screwed in the rail and the lever piece in here, so the rail is held in there pretty tight with the hex screw into the gear, the gun box. But once you put in the barrel piece, you need to do it in this order. You need to put the barrel piece in first, and then if you notice, there's a hole right here. This is meant for another hex screw. Once you pull the lever and the barrel piece pops out, the hex screw is that's supposed to be placed here is going to stop the barrel piece from coming out all the way, and it's gonna basically hit a piece of the rail right here. Now, well, first I'm gonna put this through the best that I can right now. I'm gonna show you there's ways that I would say there's of putting this in. Again, this is the top piece of the rail, because this is where your wires are going to come out on the top here and come through this little gap in the rail. So top piece, this little piece right here is angled downward. So we're just going to fit this in. All right, so I got my barrel piece fit through. Didn't take as long as I thought it was going to. It only took, a couple minutes, but so here's my wires, here's my barrel piece fitting all the way through. So this next step you can really do either way you like. I'm actually going to put in the lever piece next, or the actual lever into the lever piece in the gun box. The other thing you could do also is to have the hex screw put into the barrel piece to be able to hold it in. But at this point, this is what I'm going to work on right now is the lever piece. So putting that in, there is a hole down here underneath the trigger box, which for the way that this throwing chicken has been built, there's this extra little acrylic piece that holds the trigger box onto the gun box itself. So that has to be kind of moved out of the way because there are two screws that hold that acrylic piece. Sorry, I'll just put this down. It holds it sideways like that. You won't be able to access the hole that's supposed to be here unless you move that acrylic piece out of the way. So I just kind of unscrewed it. I've already fed all my wires through, which is what you're supposed to do. But I've bent my metal lever to my liking. Some of you, or what might be even movie accurate, is for the lever to sit like so in the Proton gun. I'm gonna move mine a little closer to the rear handle back here. I just feel like it's more comfortable, so I'm gonna do it this way. But I'm going to put the actual lever through the hole that I've drilled very carefully because inside are all my wires, and I want to make sure that I don't poke anything or smash or pinch, of course. So again, be patient, take your time, feed that through, and you're going to want to pay attention to where this guy comes out in the gun box because it's going to fit through. If you can see it in here, I'm trying to get it, but those little metal wheels that I had mentioned before to take out the little tiny screw, that is where that's going to fit through in the gun box. So I think I've got it. So I'm gonna push that all the way through and at least make sure that it gets in there. All right, so it's clearing. The lever is gonna clear pretty much the trigger box. I think I might be able to push it through a little bit further so it clears even more, but let me see if I can get that down there. I think that might be far enough. All right, so my lever is now through the metal wheels in the lever piece inside the gun box. So I'm actually going to kind of position it. I can fix this later, but I'll position that, the lever piece. I'm not too worried about the trigger box right now, but what I'm gonna do is through the back of the gearbox, I'll put this on for now, just kind of squeeze it, but this section right here is how you access. Let's see if I can get a better shot of it. Right there. So here's how you access. Right there. I'm sorry, it's a little hard to see, but this is how you access that lever piece in here, your hex screws right in there. It's much easier, actually, it might even be impossible to do it if you don't take off the grip on the handle down here. So my grip is now sitting over here, as you can see. So now this is easier for me to reach in with my wrench and tighten those screws to hold on to the lever a little easier. So I'm going to do that right now. Not too hard, not too crazy, not too tight, just enough to be able to hold it, at least for now. And then I'll tighten as I go to make sure that it's gripped enough. All right, so I've got them both on there. Pretty tight, actually. So I know I said not too tight, but actually you do want to make sure that it's gripped on there really good. So both of those screws in the back of the lever piece are tightened onto the metal lever that I fit through here. So I flip this back over. Can't see it too well, or maybe you can, but if I were to push down on the lever piece right here, or the actual lever, the lever piece on the inside moves down. You can't see it too much right now, but it's moving right now. So that is put together. What we're gonna do next is make sure that our barrel doesn't pop out any further than it's supposed to right here. So if we put our lever piece, push it down a little bit more, we're going to feed the barrel piece all the way through. Well, not all the way through, but this is what I'm going to get into next. I'll show you how to manage that part. Okay, so remember how I showed you that there's the hole, this little hole that is the very end of the barrel piece that you're supposed to fit a hex screw through. The only way to reach that, at least at this point, I mean, you could do it right now, but it's much easier for you to do it one way that this is specifically designed for, that is reaching it through the side of the gun box. So there is a hole that is supposed to be drilled between these two knob pieces on the side for you to be able to fit your wrench into the gun box to reach the hole meant for that hex screw. I did it once or twice before when I was first setting this up, didn't work, where I was just trying to put it on here and reach through on the side and screw it in, which you could do, but it is much easier if you were to do it on the side right here. You have the pressure to be able to find the hex screw. I just dropped it in there, but you find the hex screw, you put the wrench through, you find the hole, you hold it on, you fit it through and you turn it and tighten it so that the hex screw is in that little hole, the stopper screw is what we'll call it. So my, not issue with it, but my quarrel that I have with that whole thing is that you now have a hole that you have to fill with a hex screw on the outside for aesthetic purposes, so that there's not just a hole sitting back here. I feel like it, I don't know if you know, maybe this would help out future designs of how this would work, but I almost feel like that hole should be on the other side of the gun box underneath the heatsink right here. The hole can be big enough to be able to access the hex screw to fit in on this side, because the hex screw is still going to get caught on the rail, which is supposed to. It has enough room, enough space on the inside to clear it. Because it's on the barrel piece. So it would clear it if it was put in on this side. But rather than having a hole on this side of the gun box and having to fill it, maybe just put the hole on this side and make it a big enough hole to be able to reach it and just cover it with the heatsink after everything. And I might even do that later on too, if I were to take this heatsink off and I wanted to switch the side the screw is screwed in through. I'll put it in on this side through the hole that I were to drill by myself, and then put the heatsink over it. You're not going to see the hole that way. So no hole is seen if you were to move it to this side. Just a suggestion. Maybe that would work, maybe it wouldn't, but I feel like that might be a little bit easier. All right, so I've got my hex screw placed into the rail, or the barrel piece right now. I held it in with some pliers, I kind of turned it on its side, and then I placed my wrench through to find it, hold it, turn it in a little bit. So now it's just kind of in there, but I'm going to tighten it up a little bit. Just enough. Actually, we could tighten it all the way. But this doesn't need to be like tight. This just needs to be in that piece right now so that it stops when it reaches the end of the rail piece. So now if I turn this back over, flip everything over gently, get my wires out of the way so if we can get a better visual of everything. Sorry about the spaghetti. But now my barrel piece is through my rail. I got my lever piece installed. So if I were to push this through, push this all the way through, in theory, the lever piece is supposed to pull down and the hex screw that is in the lever piece is supposed to catch on that little indentation in the barrel piece. So I just reached in there and pulled it up right now. So it's holding. But the next part would be the rubber bands. At least that's what's come. That is what comes with this kit. So it comes with these little rubber bands like this. And they are supposed to hold onto these two hex screws. Kind of hard to see in here, but these two hex screws that stick out right here, there's actually other pieces that the kit comes with that I believe were meant for this. I think it works just fine without them too, but what I have done is I will pull them both, double them up, however you need to, ship in a bottle again. Manage to get two doubled rubber bands around both of these hex screws right here, so they will pinch each other and pull the rail piece and the lever piece together constantly. So I'm gonna skip past that. I'm just gonna do this on my own, and then I'll show you what that part looks like when it's installed in there. All right, so I've got my hex screw screwed into the barrel piece now, and I did that through the side with my Allen wrench. So I've pretty much got everything assembled as far as the pop mech goes. I have my rubber bands, which you could also use. I've seen people use small springs that could also work. I don't know how well these rubber bands are going to hold up over a course of time, but I've seen people use those springs, like I said. But we got the barrel piece in. We've got the rail piece screwed into the gun box. We've got your lever piece, the interior lever piece, the actual metal lever fed through the side over here. The rubber bands are holding everything together. So if I were to pull down the actual lever itself, there you go. Now, when I first did this initially, I was having a real hard time with, well, I wouldn't say a real hard time, but the actual pop itself seemed to be kind of sluggish and was sticking a little bit. I used the smallest amount of WD-40 on the rail and the barrel piece. Just kind of grease it up just the slightest little bit. I guess you could even like sand the pieces down a little bit more because they are 3D printed, but I don't know how much that's going to affect the actual functionality of the pop itself. I wouldn't want to mess up, the actual, like, have it wobble or anything like that on the inside. But again, I just use some WD-40. Again, the smallest amounts of WD-40 sprayed on the barrel piece, the interior of the rail piece. When I popped it out, I did a little bit on the interior here, on the lever piece on the inside. So nothing that's going to affect the actual mechanics or the electronics, most importantly. Just enough to be able to grease up the rail and the barrel piece enough to be able to let it slide a lot easier. So that's what we're looking at now. It helped out 100%. So I'm definitely happy with that functionality right now with everything that's set up. So I'm going to break this up. I'm actually going to pick this up probably on another section of a video, but I'm going to show you how to put in the electronics next. Connect everything, feed it, fit it through, and then make sure everything is sealed up. All right, so believe it or not, the hardest part about this build so far is done. But what we're going to do is manage all of the wiring now and fit everything into the gun box and make sure that we have enough space between them and have some separation between everything so that it doesn't get pinched in any kind of movement from the actual pop mech itself. So I'm going to skip ahead just a little bit. I'm going to connect the hardest part about this really would probably be the cable for the bar graph right here. That does take a little bit of dexterity right here. I'm going to do that pretty carefully, but once I get that in here, I'm going to show you how to kind of manage everything else. All right, so I've really got everything connected right here. So again, you want to make sure that if you don't know really where everything is going for certain, you'll want to just follow the switch, make sure that follow where it's going, keep your colors managed. What the GB fans board really has if it has like a standard setup really. The gray color is supposed to be for your fire up, I'm sorry, for your power up. So that is the bottom switch on the trigger box right here. This kind of brownish wire is your fire, so it's the intensify button on the trigger box right here. The yellow wire is the song, so that is meant for the top switch on the gun box. The purple one is the vent, which is the bottom switch on the gun box. the ear right here. So there's three wires going to one terminal. That's this guy all right here, going through the barrel or through the handle, is your light and your button up on the top up here. And then your wand tip, which is the one that is going through the barrel piece in the pop mech, which has your bulb at the very end. So this is pretty much put together right now. I have a light that is fed through to one of the hat lights down here in the top of the gun box. So I just kind of placed that down there. I don't feel like I'm really going to like glue it in there or anything if I wanted to do any kind of management later. But so here's, this is pretty much it right now. If you wanted to, zip tie or tie some of these guys together, have a little more cleanliness to your wire management, you could do that. I'm not really going to do too much more beyond what you have right here, because my main concern is to be able to fit the board into the gun box and still be able to manage all my wires as long as everything is separated from the pop mech itself. So what I have here, let me see if I have this guy, it's around here somewhere. But this little piece of, this is actually part of a placemat. So these are at the dollar store, or I mean, I guess you could use pretty much anything really, but I got this, I found this kind of material that we were using for cutting boards and placemats in the house. I cut off a little piece of it, which it's sturdy enough to be able to stay rigid, but you know, not too heavy, not too thick. It's flexible. So what I'm going to do is actually use this to separate my wires from my pop mech. So I'm going to kind of wiggle this through here and make sure that it does not, the wires don't catch on anything. Not that you would have too much to catch on, but it will alleviate any kind of concerns of anything catching at all. So just as simple as that, placed it in between there. So as you can see, my board is placed in there. My lights all fit. My wires are separate from my pop mech. My ear wires and my wand tip wires are going to sit basically just on top like that. You want to make sure that there's still room for them to be able to slide as it is, you know, as if this is extended, this wire will not catch on anything else. So you could really just lay that on top pretty much. It'll take care of itself. But that is basically everything. So I'm going to wiggle this just a little bit more. I feel like it's not completely clearing this section of where the screw is going to go right here. So I can get that in there. There we go. That seems good. All right. So I've got a couple last minute things that I wanted to discuss before I close this thing up and do a full demo. But just wanted to show you what I had as far as plans for some slight future modifications. I had done this before without having the pop mech installed in here, but originally I had a rumble motor installed in here, and this was the guy that I had used. So you can get these on GB Fans. You can get these on Amazon even. Sometimes they're made or listed as rumble motors that you can use for PlayStation controllers or Xbox controllers. There might be different sizes, but I got the larger rumble motor on the GB Fan site. It was like $4. Same prices on Amazon as well, but it comes with these short little leads right here. I just extended them, soldered them onto the 22 gauge wire that I had talked about before, wrapped them in some electrical tape so nothing really shorts or touches anything else. But originally, before I had the pop mech installed in here, I had this guy installed in the handle of the thrower here. So what I did was I pushed it through the back end of the handle without the grip on it and pushed it through with a screwdriver, and then had the wires coming through the box, and then I attached it to, you're supposed to attach it to the aux section of the GB Fans board. So if you get a little closer here, there's four more terminals here. One is meant for auxiliary or additional, like your rumble motor, or if you wanted to put in a flashbulb, which actually there's a way to be able to do both at the same time. I'm not going to go too far into that right now, but I had my rumble motor connected through the grip or the handle again. The problem with that was that the ribbon connected to the actual Proton pack is fed through here as well. So I wasn't able to get this completely still without the actual weight of the rumble motor continuing to catch and snag on the ribbon that was fed through here. I tried switching it around, did the same thing. It was a little hard for it to not hit some kind of wires or anything that was either in the box itself or coming through the handle. So I decided against that temporarily while I put in the pop mech. What I'm going to do next, or what I really would like to do, if I'm just going to be doing the rumble motor, this is what I kind of figured out. When I was building my other proton thrower, everything was made out of foam, and I was trying to find parts and everything. I had come across it, of course, you know, if you're using 1-inch PVC pipe, this is a 1-inch PVC pipe, just a little piece that I had left from the previous build that I was starting, never finished. I went to this guy. But the plan is to Dremel off or cut off this section of the thrower right here, right at the base, as close as I possibly can without nicking the box, sand it down, repaint it if I need to, and then drill a little hole through the body if there isn't a hole there already. But basically remove this part of it right here, take my 1-inch PVC, I'm gonna have to cut this down a little bit too, paint it black, do that whole thing, feed the rumble motor right through there. It'll fit. I'm gonna glue it in there. Make sure that it doesn't move. Have nothing so that the weight doesn't catch on anything. Cap it off. Maybe put another water bottle cap in there. Piece of foam, whatever I need to make sure that this is flat on top. Paint it black. This is gonna be my new rumble motor. Versus this guy right here. So it's the exact same size. It'll fit right on top. I'm just gonna epoxy glue it right there. Won't have to extend the wires. It's just gonna feed right into the aux section of the board right there. So that's the plan. I'm gonna do that later on. There's no real rush to have to do that right now, but that's what I'm looking to do. Now, again, I just wanna kind of highlight some of the things that I had done for this guy here as far as the build overall, and then I'll do the demo. But one of the things that you will notice with the throwing chicken build, I'm actually just gonna put this back on here temporarily so I can flip it over. Again, I have a little bit of a hole right in the body right here because I had drilled through accidentally when I was trying to clear out that mounting piece in there, but the throwing chicken's spot for where you're supposed to put the green hose into the slow blow part of the box, the hole that it fits into doesn't really fit the barb that you're supposed to put the hose onto, and it's just kind of part of the build really. But what you should do, I kind of overdid it with the epoxy, but I use Gorilla epoxy clear glue to make sure that that barb stays straight and solid in there. So I put a little too much. You can kind of see the shininess on there. I'm gonna wind up painting over that with some matte black. I'll clean it up and make it look nicer, but functionally, that is the best way to make sure that this barb, the brass barb for the hose, stays on there perfectly straight. So you'll put just enough on the end of that barb there, sit it, twist it, whatever you need to make sure that it's in there completely and straight, and let it sit. So let it sit overnight. It's supposed to dry in 5 minutes. I just left it overnight. It's the best way to ensure that everything stays. And then I put the green hose on there. So that is nice and secure right there. But other than that, got my new switches, nice and solid right here. These I did myself off of the GB fans board. I removed the old ones. Here's a piece of that, the green hose right here on top of my lever. I got aluminum pieces from GB fans. This is the resin clipper that came with the entire throwing chicken kit. I got the hat lights that came with the kit. Again, the banjos came with the kit as well. I got my own screws. The acrylic tube I got from GB Fans. The metal piece at the end here I got from GB Fans. And then I did the whole method of using a zip tie to connect my flex, I'm sorry, my split loom to the handle. So the ribbon's flowing through here. The split loom is fed through just enough to be able to kind of, I put little holes in the split loom here, fed the zip tie through, twisted it around. Took me a couple minutes, but I also put some electrical tape on there just to kind of make sure that it's nice and sturdy. But I've seen a couple different ways of doing this. That's just what I did there. But yeah, that is the overall build of everything. Now I'm going to do the demo. Thanks very much. Appreciate you watching. Like and share. Subscribe, comment. Let me know what your thoughts are. If there's anything else that I can fix, touch up, correct, paint over, redo, improve later on. But just trying to help out the GB fans out there. The whole fandom of building Proton packs. Hopefully this helps out, guys.